What's good guys, this is Haseem Wali and I'm back with another video. I hope you're all having a great day, and if you haven't already, please follow me on my Instagram handle @HaseemWali10 and also follow me on my Facebook Haseemania Fitness, and I'll also post the handles down below in the description box. So now let's get back to the video. So guys, the first thing that we need to focus on is how to calculate your maintenance calories. Now you might be wondering, what are your maintenance calories? So guys, your maintenance calories are the calories, by its obvious name, is the calories that will help you maintain your body weight. Now how do you figure that out? So the first thing that you need to keep in mind is you won't be able to figure those out in the first week by itself. You need to give it some time. So at least give it 2 weeks to figure the process out. And if you feel like you are increasing your weight, then you are in a surplus of calories. And if you feel like you are losing your weight really quickly, then you are in a deficit of calories. So the first thing that you need to keep in mind is you need to calculate your maintenance calories. So now guys, how do you calculate your maintenance calories? So the first thing that you need to do is, and an easy way that I'll give you and an efficient way that I'll give you to calculate those maintenance calories is, I'll help you out by putting those links down in the description box below. So the first thing I'll do is, you can go to the bodybuilding website, the links that I'll be putting down below, and you can calculate your calories as well as your macros as well down there. So now you guys might be wondering, what are your macros? Guys, your macros are your carbs, proteins and fats. So you can also calculate how many carbs and proteins and fats you need to hit as per your goal. So guys, now let's get back to the next point of this video, and that point will be, choose a goal. And what I mean by choosing a goal is, whether you want to maintain your physique, whether you want to build muscle, or whether you want to lose fat. Choose a goal. Having a goal will help you throughout the process, in the terms of, especially if you are a natural lifter, because you can't build muscle and lose fat at the same time, especially as a natural lifter. That is not possible. Maybe if you are a beginner, then you will be able to do that, but as an advanced or an intermediate lifter, you won't be able to add muscle and lose fat at the same time. It helps out, but it won't be as effective. So you need to keep one thing in mind that is very important, is you need to pick a goal that you will follow. Whether it is to lose fat, whether it is to put on muscle, or whether it is just to maintain your physique, you need to choose a goal. So with that being said guys, let's move on to the next point. And the next point would be, how to figure out your macros. So the first thing that you need to know is, the calories that proteins and carbs consist are the same, and fats contain 9 calories per gram, and your protein will consist 4 calories per 1 gram, and your carbs will consist 4 calories per 1 gram, and your fats will consist 9 calories per 1 gram. So you need to design your meal plan in accordance to that. You can't add a lot of fats and hit your goal, especially if your goal is to lose fat. So you need to keep that in mind very rigidly in order to know what your goals are. So now the next thing that you need to keep in mind is, your 40 to 60% of your calories should come from carbs. Maybe you can hit your 25 to 35% through your protein, and you can hit your fats, that is 15 to 25% through that, because fats has more calories and protein has a satiation effect. And what I mean by that satiation effect is, protein helps you fill up, because protein has the highest thermic effect of food. And what I mean by highest thermic effect of food is, protein digests slowly. So what that helps you do is, protein metabolizes slowly. So if anything is metabolizing slowly, then you won't be hungry for the next few hours, because you have eaten more protein. Especially if you are trying to lose your weight, if you are trying to cut down, I would recommend you go higher on your protein and then your carbs, and then reduce your fat. So moving on to the next point guys, that would be, how to calculate whether you want to lose fat, whether you want to maintain your physique, or whether you want to add muscle. So while if you are trying to add muscle, then you should go on a 100 to 200 calorie surplus. If you are trying to lose weight, then I would recommend on going on a 300 to 500 calorie deficit. And if you are trying to maintain your physique, then it's obvious you need to save on your maintenance calories. So with that being said, let's move on to the last part and to the last point of this video, and that would be calculating your calories. Now there are a few apps for that, which I will also link down in the description box below. There's a Healthify Me app for that, and there's also MyFitnessPal. Now the one thing that you need to keep in mind is the calories that you will be calculating won't always be accurate. So you need to keep that in mind. You need to just ballpark your calories, you just need to keep an estimate of your calories. The calories that you are calculating won't ever be fully 100% accurate. And it doesn't matter. As long as you are hitting your protein, carbs and fats goals, it doesn't matter if your calories are fully accurate or not. If your macros are fully accurate or not. Just keep one thing in mind, and that is to hit your goal of calories. Now sometimes it might be higher, sometimes it might even be lower, or sometimes you might just be eating or maintaining, which it does not matter as much in the long run, because your calorie tracking won't always be accurate. And the next thing that you need to keep in mind is the macros that you are calculating from these apps, the calories that you are calculating for your maintenance or trying to build muscle or trying to lose fat won't always be accurate, and you need to keep that in mind very rigidly. So the thing you need to focus on is just take a ballpark, take an estimate and go with that. It won't always be very accurate, so don't over focus and don't obsess over the fact that you are not accurate with your calories. And with this, guys, I'm going to end today's video. And if you like the video, please show some love by hitting the like button. Comment down in the comment section below if you have any further queries, and also subscribe to this channel and don't forget to press on the notification bell. With this, guys, have a nice day. See you guys.